How's it going, guys? This is Epic Super Noob here bringing you some Firewatch Let's Play. Let's get into it. I don't know what episode we're on now, so yeah. So let's get into it.
Not too bad. I could get used to it out here.
That's nice.
Look at that.
Look, I called with bad news. Two young women, Chelsea Stevens and Lily McLean, were reported missing.
Oh my god.
They've got parents out in California who haven't heard from them in a week. They were supposed to meet an aunt down in Cody. If they're the girls from last week, then you're probably the last person to have seen them.
You should tell whoever that I'm happy to be questioned.
Look, it's not gonna be an issue. I mean, if they turn up dead, then maybe. Should I just not say anything and save us the trouble?
I think it's worth mentioning something.
Yeah. I'll keep it vague. I really don't want to talk to the cops.
Me neither.
All right, Henry, thanks. Enjoy the sunset.
I am. That is just stunning. Wow, we're skipping through the days here. So I feel like what I'm thinking is that figure that shined a light at me earlier hurt those poor little children. And that's my story, and I'm sticking to it.
Henry, wake up.
What?
Out of bed and pick up the radio.
What do you want, woman?
What do you want?
Hey, you big dumb idiot.
Hi, Jules.
Oh, you sound tired.
I am.
Are you having a nice time?
Sure. Are you? Everything good there? Jules?
What? Oh, sorry, Henry. Yeah, I'm good.
Well, that's good.
Well, I'll let you get back to sleep then.
Okay, Jules.
Delilah seems nice.
Sure.
Bye, baby.
Whoa. I feel like I'm slowly starting to lose my mind. This is a great game. I'm liking this. Okay, I'm going to the supply drop.
Is it too much of a pain in the ass to bring supplies all the way up to our towers?
Well, I get my stuff hand-delivered.
Oh, how's that work?
It's the perks of a decade of service. You're out hiking in 90-degree heat, and I get to do crosswords. Isn't life miserably unfair? Anyway, when you find the supply drop, remember it's not just for you, okay? Other lookouts, biologists, a few people get their food there, and I don't want to have to call in for more. There should be loads of good stuff, though. Beans, prunes, jerky. You know, my sister eats 6 prunes a day. 6. She's, like, really precise about it. She'd be great at this job if she didn't need wheelbarrows full of marijuana to function.
Okay.
So, like, 2 weeks ago, you called me in the middle of the night? You were sleeping, I guess, and all I heard was the name Jules through the mumbles. I just thought it was so sweet. I wanted to wake you up, but then I thought maybe you were having a nice conversation and I'd just be spoiling it. I hope you're doing okay, you know, when it comes to her.
I'm doing fine.
I am.
Good. I'm glad. Look. So, a couple of months before I took this job, I was with this guy, Javier. Ugh, he's incredible, caring, sexy as hell. He was a driller down in Casper. We dated for almost 5 years. I was working with the Wyoming Outdoor Leadership School, and I was obsessed with it. I wanted to be an instructor so badly. And I was sure I was going to marry Javier as soon as I could be bothered. Waltz was also a good excuse to get out of town, drink whiskey in the mountains, cut loose. Then, Javier's brother got killed working in Gillette, and for some reason, I didn't come home. Javier said it was fine, he'd go to the funeral, take care of his mom, stuff like that, it'd be easier solo. When he came back, he left me. I came out here, I lied and told my sister he fucked our neighbor.
Well, I hopped down a drop and now I can't climb back up.
That is a pickle.
I can just keep hiking, but I figured I should let you know in case I get myself trapped out here.
How adventurous of you.
I've been doing a lot more climbing out here than I expected.
Well, keep your radio charged. I'd hate to one day find a skeleton with an orange backpack at the bottom of a ravine.
Which one am I?
I got everything I need out of here. Time to chow down.
Just yours, right?
Who do you think I am?
Yeah, I'm gonna take somebody else's.
You've got a front row seat for what might be the biggest fire of the year.
Yeah, it's really going.
I'm gonna call it in. They'll send in a hotshot crew for some suppression, but I bet we'll be stuck with her for the rest of the summer. And she doesn't have a name yet. I usually think of something funny or something practical or a little risque when coming up with them. But why don't you do the honors?
Delilah's a nice name.
No, you big dummy.
I was kidding.
No, you were not. You're sweet, but we can't call it the Delilah Fire.
Okay, what then?
How about my middle name, June?
The June Fire, even though it's July.
I like it. So there's this creek down the hill, and, you know what my favorite thing to do is?
What's that?
I love to take a bottle of whatever I have on hand, plunge it deep into the water, and let it chill in there all day. And then, on nights like tonight, when it is so disgustingly hot, I have something nice and cool to drink. I learned that from my sister in Santa Fe. She'd do that with a bottle of tequila near her house and make margaritas the size of your head. You'd like it there.
If I was there with you, I'm sure I would like it a lot.
Are you looking at the fire?
No, I'm not.
You should. Let me know when you are.
Okay, I'm looking at it again.
I love how they look at night. During the day, it's just smoke, but when the sun is down, you can just get lost.
Yeah.
I'm glad you're here.
Why do you say that?
Because I do. I'm not crazy. I mean, we've had such a good time, right?
Yeah, I think so.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you. Not in the same way. And I know you're not really available, but I want you to know, well, maybe it'd be nice to get together at the end of the summer. Look, we don't have to plan or even talk about it. I'm just having the thought. I wish I was over there.
I wish you were too.
We could sit outside. We could talk without these radios. We could, you know.
What? What could we do?
Well, let me tell you.
Ooh. It's getting a little bit risky.
You better get somebody a pussy.
Okay.
You're going fishing without a license?
It's one fish, and I'm sick of all the stuff I got to eat.
Well, I won't tell anyone you're a poacher.
Alright.
That reminds me, I keep hearing reports from Fish and Game about a problem bear they're trying to keep tabs on. Can you search around the lake for fresh tracks and just let me know what you find? There was a crew burning fire lines out to the east, and, you know, I think sometimes it riles up the wildlife.
Does problem actually mean murderer? Like how Charles Manson is a problem cult leader?
Oh, come on. You just have to look for tracks. That's it.
Giant.
Can't believe I'm gonna leave this planet as a pile of bear shit.
Thank you, Henry.
Yeah.
Okay, let's catch a fish. Lake's really pretty.
Someone left their clipboard out here.
Huh. It could have been one of the Fish and Game folks. See if there's a name or a credential or something. I can call it in.
Hey, no. Get that back.
What? It's... Holy shit.
What's going on? You didn't actually find a bear, did you?
Someone has written down what we said to each other, have been saying.
That doesn't make any sense.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you, not in the same way.
No way.
This is creepy.
Wait, hold on. Something's out here.
Henry? I'm worried. You didn't find and eat any mushrooms, did you? I mean, they can be fun, but also, you know, devastating. Regardless, just let me know, okay, Buckaroo? Oh god, I don't know why I just called you that.
Where's the canyon?
I found a walkie-talkie out here, too.
Okay.
It's going.
Oh, shit. Whoa. That scared the crap out of me.
Henry, are you there?
What happened, Henry?
I got hit in the head. Punched or something by someone.
Oh, my God.
Are you serious? What the hell is going on out there?
I don't know. Jesus Christ.
Let me get this straight. You found a clipboard with, what, transcripts of our conversations? What else is on it?
I don't know. It's gone, along with a radio of theirs. Somebody out here could have just killed me, Delilah.
I don't... What the fuck is going on?
What's Wapiti Station?
I don't know.
I saw the name Wapiti Station right before I was cold cocked. Does Wapiti Station mean anything to you?
Wapiti Meadow. Maybe it's Wapiti Meadow. It's on our maps. It's not too far from where you are right now. It's where you saw that damn fence. It's north of the lake. It looks like there should be a trail somewhere on the north shore of Jonesy Lake.
I'll start hiking that way now. God damn it, my head.
Are you sure you saw what you saw, Henry? Maybe you pissed off some more campers and they came back to sucker punch you.
Look, I know what I saw. Hey, it was our words with initials for our names, H and D, clear as day.
And you've been feeling okay?
I feel fine.
Okay, I'm sorry. I believe you, but that conversation was from 2 weeks ago.
I know they were. So what's to say that they don't have transcripts from 3, 4, or 5 weeks ago?
Our entire relationship, friendship, our whole summer.
Someone is out here with a walkie-talkie, taking notes and talking to God knows who. What do you think is going on behind that fence?
Apparently a lot of following you around taking notes, which is unfucking believable, Henry.
Okay, I'm at the fence. I don't see anyone around, but I'm not sure I can get past it.
How big is it?
Big. It goes off in both directions, acres.
But what the fuck is going on out here?
Whatever it is, someone doesn't want anyone to know about it. Looks like goddamn Area 51.
Maybe they've got aliens. That'd be exciting.
We'll see about that. And the gate is locked up, obviously. Look, I'm not gonna be able to get into this place.
Shit.
I don't know how long I can stick around out here until someone notices.
God, if you were an actual firefighter, you'd have that gate down in two shakes. Hey, actually, those guys doing the controlled burn, they might be able to help.
Where are they?
Beyond Ruby River, there's a scout camp. They burned a line a few days ago that should let you hike right to them.
Well, that's great.
If they haven't left, they're probably the type of guys who would help you get through that fence.
Ruby River. So there's a fence on both sides. I feel like this is it. Okay. Go on, you go faster. Okay. Let me find Ruby River. Hang on my map. South of Ruby River. Scout camp. That's all on the other friggin' side. Where I got clocked. No worries, no worries, no worries. Trying to catch me a darn fish. Alright, I'm heading the right way. As long as I'm heading, right, I'm heading more east. All right, let's keep going. This is really weird.
I'm wandering around east of the lake. Which way is Ruby River?
It's in the southeast corner of your map. The scout camp where the firefighters were staged should be on your map. It looks like a little triangle with a flat bottom.
Yeah, it looks like a tent.
How did I never see that before?
Okay, so she said south, east, so I'm heading the right way. Okay, which one do I take? So my right one goes that way. Go left. Go that way. So I'm gonna take this one.
Hey,
Well, it seems I've already been this
way. Hey, I called around. Things seem normal with everyone else.
Has anything strange been happening on your end?
No, nothing really.
Nothing really or nothing?
Nothing. My door was open the other night, but that's not strange.
That doesn't sound like nothing.
It's nothing, I promise.
All right, I'm headed toward the camp anyway.
Why is my frame rate just dropping?
Keep your radio close to you.
Hey, what you just said, keep my radio close to me.
Yeah?
Before I got attacked back at the lake, I saw a radio on the ground, kind of like the one I use.
And?
Do you think that maybe someone was, you know,
I don't know. What?
Maybe intercepting our frequency with other radios or something.
Henry.
It's just a thought.
I don't even know how you would do that.
Yeah, well, you sound worried.
No, I'm not. Okay, let's not spin out of control. Just keep hiking.
Whatever you say, boss.
So when I get up here, I'm taking this way. Ooh, hang on. I need to go. I need to go this way. Right, this game is really interesting. It's popping off now, boys.
I know we don't know what's going on yet, but I don't have a good feeling.
Well, what is that?
I don't like feeling vulnerable. It's not like you can just call the police. I was thinking about the Goodwins. It just struck me that if anything weird like this happened to them, happened to Brian, just how scared he would have been.
Wow, there's an old, I think it's called a medicine wheel out here?
Yeah, it was made by Crow American Indians hundreds of years ago. There are lots of small ones. Have you ever been to Medicine Wheel Monument over in the Bighorns? Anyway, I don't expect you to care as much about it. I'm probably just working myself up into a tizzy over nothing. Sorry, we just need to focus on what's happening to us.
I love that the music makes you feel like you're alone. I like that. This is me, moving. Oh, that's cool. I like that. Wait, fuck, did I go the wrong way? No, sorry, I went the right way. My frame rate drops, like... Okay, there's a fence. I knew it.
Well, the June fire isn't going anywhere, huh?
No, that's why those guys came out to burn that line. It's at the stage where all we can do is pay attention to it.
They're not gonna try to put it out?
Not yet, apparently.
Hey, my toilet paper.
I found where they did the controlled burn. I can hike right through here now.
Yeah, normally they wouldn't do that so close to a body of water, but I think they're extra worried about a fire jumping the river and burning up to Two Forks, now that there's someone in it.
Well, I'm extra appreciative of that.
Let's see. The scout camp is southeast of the river. There should be a pond on the way.
Got it. What happens if a controlled burn gets out of control?
Someone gets fired.
Ugh, are you serious?
Oh, come on. That one was an honest accident. I'm not even in the mood for wordplay. That's how wound up all this shit has me.
There's some old snowmobiles out here.
That's crazy.
Looks like one of the poor bastards was cruising across this pond and dumped it.
That was not a fun hike back to civilization.
There's an old pond out here, not much more than a pile of mud. Do you have it on your map?
Yeah, I know where you are.
Yeah? Where am I?
Pork Pond. There used to be a sign up for it, but, well, folks kept stealing it.
Because it's called Pork Pond?
It's a good goddamn name. That sign would look great in a den, or, you know, anywhere.
I feel like she has one in her lookout tower. Alright, I'm close. This must be it. Camp Arapaho.
The bridge to the camp is out.
Damn.
I'm gonna walk the ravine and see if I can find some high ground to get across.
Good plan.
What?
Strong enough to climb back up some of these drop-offs, but here I am, stuck.
Yeah, well, we've all got our limits, Henry.
Alrighty. What the fuck?
I'm at the camp.
Great. Have a look around. If anyone's still there, they might be able to help.
I guess these little shelters are where they keep the Weeblos.
For the past 35 years, yeah.
That sign.
There are bear traps out here in the scout shelters.
Scouts are stalwart prey.
That's messed up.
This one has a tree growing through it. These haven't been here. These haven't been used in a while.
Yeah, these guys are gone. I found where they were sitting around before getting picked up.
Yes, I want
Damn.
It.
I found an axe.
If one of the crew left it, that thing is actually called a Pulaski.
It looks like an axe to me. This thing will be a huge help.
For both getting through the backcountry and getting through that fence.
Hmm. Hey, Dee, they left...
Well, then you just yash out crew.
Something behind. It's like a memo from their boss.
Did it say anything of note?
Next few days, dropping into the thoroughfare on behalf of Dr. Simmons at Wapiti Station.
Wapiti Station?
Holy crap.
Keep reading.
Oh, I just thought I would maybe, you know, stop there, let the mystery percolate.
My mother always said I would need someone to give me a taste of my own medicine.
They're running a research site out there. He was worried about wildfires.
Someone is writing down our conversations. And now we find out there's a research site out here that we don't know about? What are they researching?
Us. They're researching us.
You think they're studying you and me?
I do, yeah. I mean, maybe it's about studying two strangers who talk every day.
Like, if you put someone in isolation with someone else, what they do?
Yeah, that's what I think.
Well, fuck that.
Agreed.
I think we should allow for the possibility that this is all just a big misunderstanding, but... God, if you saw what you said you did... Fuck, Henry.
Yeah, yeah. I saw it.
Okay. So what's next?
I've got an axe, so I can figure out a way to get over the ravine and back towards the site.
Sounds good. Check in when you can, and keep an eye out for anyone following you.
Someone wants to tell me something. All right. Return to Wapiti Meadow.
Are you there? I had a thought.
Let's hear it.
You heard someone in the bushes.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's assume we're being tailed. Or you are, at least. Where are you right now?
Just on my way back, in and out of trees, in the middle of nowhere.
Do you see anybody?
No, definitely not.
All right, so tell me what you think of this. Did you just cough?
No. Did you just cough?
No.
Oh,
fuck.
There isn't any way someone, like, another lookout could be on this line, is there?
No. Not without tapping our radios.
Well, what about when I heard you talking to someone else?
I just left your line open. That's not what this is. Get in your tower, shut the door. Don't leave, and don't use your radio. I'll call you. Understand? I will call you.
Ooh, hoo, hoo. That one's a good one to end on. So, thank you guys so much for watching this episode of Firewatch Let's Play. If you guys enjoy this, please like and subscribe, and you know, keep this series going. You know, if you like it, comment down below what you like about it. Comment down below what you think is gonna happen. All right, later.